QR codes are all the rage. Let's learn how to generate them from your app. I've already set up a storyboard of a simple app to display a square image view. I also set up a function to make a QR code. So let's go over to the view controller here. I'll close this up. And you can see right here, I've got my outlet. I've got a QR code image that I've made optional. And right under that, I've got that QR code. And the first thing I'm going to do, just for good cleaning purposes, is I'm going to make that QR code image nil. Now, if the text is going to be empty, I'm going to return with a blank image. And so we're going to do if text is empty, return, so we don't spend a lot of time processing. And we generate the QR codes and other barcodes as CI filters. So I'm going to have to make a filter. The initializer for the filter returns an optional. So I'm going to use guard to unwrap it. So G-U-A-R-D, and then let filter equal. And I'm going to use a CI QR code generator filter. So I'm going to make it CI filter name, and then in quotes, CI QR code generator. And then just return if it fails that. I'm going to need another guard to change the text to data format. So I'm going to do another guard here. I'll take the text and go to data using, and I'll use the allow lossing conversion here. And I'm going to put in the using ISO Latin 1, because that's the preferred one according to Apple. And then right here for allowed lossing conversion, I'm going to make that false. Okay, then we'll have to do an else return. All right, so I've got my filter, I've got my data, and now I'm going to set the two values for the filter, and the first one will be the data itself, and I'm going to do filter set value, and my value is going to be my data, and the key here is input message. I got one more value to set for this, and that's the input correction level. There's several levels, L for low, M for medium, Q for quality, and H for high. This adds extra data to the QR code to deal with dirt and other corruption of the image. As the quality increases, the amount of data increases. So I'm going to go for M for medium in this case. And so I'm going to do filter, set value. And my value is going to be an M. And the key here is the input correction level. And now I'm ready to get the image from the filter. So I'll do QR code image equals filter dot output image. And that's all optional with the QR code image ending up as an optional value. So I'm going to do an if let here to unwrap it, and then inside here, I'm going to now put this in the image view. And I'm going to need to make this a UI image. So I'm going to say UI image here, and then I need a CI image, which is right here. And I can put the QR code image like that. Now, if you head on down to view did load, you'll see that I've already put in here a URL, which is one of the things you'll probably use these for the most. But this could be any text. I could put I love pizza in here, for example. And go ahead and set your simulator iPhone XR. And go ahead and run. If you have a phone handy, open the camera app or the QR code app, which you'll find on the control panel if you've set it up. But it's really just the camera app, so I'm just going to use the camera here and point it at your QR code. And you'll see almost immediately you get an notification that says it wants to open something. And I'm going to go ahead and hit the notification, and it goes into LinkedIn Learning and the tips. You can change the filter to other formats. These include a variety of 1D barcodes and 2D data matrices. With these filters, many of your barcode needs can easily be generated in your apps.